So, got these cut out, and it will come out where this heater comes up. So now I've got to replace, I got to move that. This is getting moved to the other side. It's going to be underneath the couch. We want to keep it. So what I'm going to end up doing is I got to look underneath. Well, we're going to disconnect it here. And I got a bucket so we can save any fluids that leak out. And let's see what's underneath. Hopefully we can disconnect it and quickly we'll just move this outside, connect it back up, or loop it somehow, and then for later install. So let's see what's underneath. Hi everybody. First off, you may notice different pair of glasses. I got some sawdust in my right eye the other day. Had to go to the doctor's, and just enough breeze blowing it around and scratched the eye up a little bit. Meds now, I'm good, but I found these nice safety glasses fit a little bit tighter, and I can actually see better out of these than wear my regular glasses. And these ones have little like bifocal lenses for in close work. I wish I'd found these years ago. Anyway, today's project is relocating this heater. And if you remember from when I built the settee, it was in the way, so we pulled it out, just replumbed it up so that it the antifreeze wasn't going all over the place. Today we're going to move it to the other side of this doorway, which will be under the sofa. A lot of people are probably asking why not just get rid of it? Why not do like most people do and just cut the lines and loop it? I sort of wish I'd kept one of mine, but mine was it was toast. It was rotted right out. So I getting rid of mine was a non-issue. This one still works. And if you're driving down the road, there's two reasons. Right now, we're in Arizona. It's going to get warmer, and the engine might get warm. You want to get rid of some more heat. You could turn this on. It's another radiator. So if you're doing a lot of hills and things are getting hot, it'll help cool things down. The other reason is, why not have heat while you're driving down the road? You can use it to keep the cab or keep the bus warm. That way you're not running any supplemental heat. So a couple of reasons to keep it. And so right now we're gonna get into relocating the heater. So these are the two hoses that go to the heater, and they connect up here and dive through the floor. And I don't know what's down below, but we're gonna find out. But the first thing I wanna do is to try to pinch off this hose to minimize how much antifreeze can come down through. So I'll try to do that on both of these hoses. And if I can pinch it off completely, then we won't lose as much antifreeze. And hopefully it'll drain off from here and we won't make a mess on the floor inside. That's the plan. The next step, obviously, is going to be taking these hoses off of here and letting the antifreeze that's in the system drain back out. Hopefully it'll just be that little bit that's in that section of hose. fun with this is this right here is the battery box. And instead of the hoses like going just over to the frame, of course, this is the one of the compressors for the old air conditioner, and that's coming out sometime real soon. But instead of going out and around, they got a 90, another 90 on the other side of the box, another 90, then another 90 that goes up through the floor. So I'm gonna just deconstruct this, and I'm not sure. I think I gotta take it apart a piece at a time, and hopefully we'll be able to have a piece hose long enough to tie it all together. We'll see. So, does it look like I'm having fun? Because I am. I have a lot of definition of fun, obviously. In order to go from the where I came over the wheel well, all of about 5 feet just past this doorway, going around this battery box, took all of that short pieces of hose, 90 degrees, I think each one had 5, 6 90 degree angles, plus a couple of weird ones where it came in and looped back. So finally, a couple hours later, big mess. You notice different safety glasses. The other ones let a little piece of this insulation is 26 years old. It seems like it gives, but it just cracks up and powders up. Some of that got in my eye, the one that I had crap in 3 days ago. So flush that out and kept going. Put these on, these seal up a little bit better. Anyhow, all that's out. Next step is to clean up, and we'll get the heater in place, figure out what kind of hose I need, and if I have any connections in this mess that I can use. So let's get to that. After stripping out all of the various connections, I ended up with 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 90s, and that one funky, interesting one that all that just to come down through the floor, go around a battery box, and come back up through the floor 5 feet later as a crow flies or a student walks. Oh well. Well, the next step is putting this stuff all back together so that the heater can be installed, and I'm going to reuse a lot of these fittings. But after 26 years, you get pieces of crud on these, and the hose is just baked on. So I can use a wire brush to try to get them off, but I think it's going to go a lot better if I char them off first. So I'm going to very carefully heat these up, hanging on to them because I've learned about burned fingers, with some channel locks, and I'll char up the ends and then hopefully be able to wire brush off the ash and get them cleaned up enough that we can reuse them. Like the smell of burning rubber in the morning. that cleaned up pretty nice. Now I just got to do the rest of it.
All right, time for me to make up the connections. And this is the old line coming in where it dove underneath. We'll have to pull all that out. And as I showed you, I messed up one of these big pieces, which is too bad, but I can make it up with a couple of 90s. And matter of fact, you know, I got a whole lot of them. And the hose clamps I took off actually were ones that had a hex head, and these that I bought to replace do not. So I'll just use the screwdriver. I'm not going to super tighten these down. I'm just going to take them down so that they're relatively tight, and then hand tighten them from there, because I don't want to over tighten these. It's real easy when you to strip out these line, or you know, the where the screw works, and you end up with a hose clamp that fails and leaks, and we don't want that. So I just take it in till it's relatively tight, and then I'll hand tighten it from there.
Unfortunately, when the bus was being demoed by whoever it was, they didn't cut the hoses. They left it all hooked up, but they cut the wires. And there's two sets of wires coming in here, both the same colors. We'd been nice if they were different, but all I can do is I'll strip these back and I will hook them up, and we'll see if we have power. I think what happens is that on the switch, there's probably two positions. One turns one fan on, second one turns the second fan on, so high, low. And so let me get the stripping and connecting the wires up temporarily, and we'll see what that does. So I'm going to put a series of holes, but because if I put them just single ones down, then it would give the potential for it to rock too much. So I'm going to put screws on either side. And so I'm going to put, like one here, and then I'll alternate down through. So I very cleverly marked on the floor where this is going to go. So now I can just attach it. So yesterday we played around with the wires to see what would go to the switch, and I did leave quite a bit extra. So to get over here, I need about that much. And we did realize early on that this originally was bolted to a seat, so it was grounded. So I added a ground wire, ground it to the chassis, and I will zip tie this so it's all nice out of the way, not going to get sucked into the fan. But I know I've mentioned them before, but I like these little connectors. Once I strip the wire down, get it straightened out, all I got to do
You shove it in, and it latches on. And then I'll strip down this wire and connect them up to the right ones, and it's all nice and tidy. Now the heater's moved, reinstalled, and there's two switches for it. And let me move you closer, and hopefully you won't be able to see the fans, but you'll be able to hear them. First fan, I pull it once, it's on high, pull it all the way out, it goes on low. The other fan, once on high, all the way out on low. And that's moving some air. I'm up by the driver's seat and I can feel the air moving. So that's going to throw a lot of heat when they're driving. So now the last thing to do is going to be take the clamps off the hoses and refill the radiator with the engine, then get the engine running that's pumping through all this and check for leaks. Hopefully we don't have any.